Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Weekend Preview. I'm Darkseid Phil. Welcome to my humble abode. Today is Sunday, August 31st, 2014, and let us talk. Let us talk about this past week, and let's talk about what's in the coming week, because this past week was a different week. It was a lot different than usual. There was some stuff going on that, in particular, wasn't normal because of the amount of releases that had come out, right, within a short period of time. Because of a special day with my girlfriend's birthday being celebrated this past Friday. And so everything was kind of thrown into a different style of order of content that maybe you weren't used to. And so let me review what I did this week very briefly. Number one, we were continuing on with the Tales of Exilia 2 playthrough. I did upload more videos of it, but it did go on hiatus because I was not able to play anymore because of the 5 new releases this week. Number two, Street Fighter videos. There were actually 3 batches of Street Fighter videos uploaded this week, including Rose, M. Bison, and Dan, all in separate playlists on my YouTube channel, DSP Gaming. So you can check those out if you didn't get a chance yet. I started all these new games, including Madden 15, where I did career mode, and then earlier today I did the ultimate team mode. So I did 2 longer streams of Madden 15, so you can check those out if you would like. I'm going to be honest with everyone at this point. The overwhelming feedback I'm getting is that the game is boring. I can't make the game of American football any more exciting besides sitting here raging, and really the game's not making me rage that much. I really have no desire to play it online because I don't want to play it competitively. I was enjoying the simulation modes, but people are telling me it's not that good, so if it's not that good, we got way too much content to not be, or not way too many games to play to be playing a game people aren't liking. So that's probably going to be it for the Madden 15 content, quite honestly, okay? We had The Walking Dead Season 2 finale, which was great. I liked it. I stood by my choices. I kept the choices that I had picked in it, even though people were saying I got like one of the worst endings. I don't care. People love the playthrough, as usual with The Walking Dead. They flocked to it. They watched the hell out of it. The stream, unfortunately, sucked ass because Twitch TV was all screwed up at the time. But lots of people watched it on YouTube. Check that out if you haven't had a chance. It's the end of Season 2, and we don't know when Season 3 is coming out, right? Okay, what else did we do? Wednesday we did the Dark Souls 2 Crown of the Old Iron King DLC paired with Infamous First Light, the standalone DLC for Infamous 2. Quite honestly, I'll be honest with you, I thought that the Dark Souls 2 DLC was weak, and I thought that Infamous First Light was horrible. I think Infamous First Light was very boring and repetitive and was like 1/10 of the content of the main game, and it was like a watered-down version of the main game. And the Dark Souls 2 DLC just wasn't very inspired, in my opinion. I think it was dialed in. It was a lot shorter than the last one. It even had a recycled boss. And it finally got to the point that I had to respec my character to even beat it. So I was really frustrated with it. But I did get through it. And people were even saying, wow, we're so surprised that Phil beat the final boss of that DLC so quickly, because it took a lot of people a long time to beat him. And I beat him on like the third try, I think it was. And then, come this Friday, I went and celebrated Leanna's birthday with her in Seattle. We went to Seattle Zoo. It's called Woodland Park Zoo, actually. And we did all these vlogs, and some of those vlogs are live on the King of Hate vlog. Some I have not uploaded yet, but we'll be uploading over the course of this week. And yesterday, I started my big, very first Nintendo 3DS playthrough. What was it? Professor Layton versus Phoenix Wright, and boy, was that great. I'm loving the game. It's so good. I'm thinking it's a Game of the Year contender for me. I'm doing voice acting for it, and people are loving it. They're saying, we're loving your voice acting. You're putting a lot of work into it. Please continue to do it, and please continue that game this week. So, if anything, my favorite thing that I did this past week, quite honestly, is Layton versus Wright, and that's going to be continuing on this coming week. So, that's great, right? All right. So, today, as I said, I already played some Madden. We're doing the Week in Preview. And immediately following this Week in Preview, I'm going to be doing a mini stream in the beginning of a new weekly series where I'm, every Sunday night, going to be checking out Tomodachi Life live here on stream and also recording it and uploading it to my YouTube channel, DSP Gaming. And this is cool because it's something on the 3DS that's completely unique. It's not like a game that you could do a full playthrough of, per se. It's not like as a campaign, but it's fun. The simulation that I'm doing, John Rambo's in there, Howard's in there, OJ and Leanna are in there, and then you've got video game characters, you've got wrestlers, you've got celebrities, actors, singers, everyone in there. I have a class of 24 right now, and I'm actually planning on doing more in the future. So I'm really excited to do that, and to do that once a week. Now, it's not going to be any huge amount of footage. At the most, it'll be an hour and a half, but more than likely, it's going to be 45 minutes to an hour. That's a game that really, if you do it in small doses, it's great. If you try to play it for a long period of time, it just becomes boring and too much. So that's why every week a little bit, until finally people say, well, Phil, this feels played out. We don't want to see it anymore. So that's how that's going to work. So that starts tonight, immediately following the week in preview. So stick around if you're watching this on stream for some good stuff coming up immediately following it, okay? So what's going to happen this week? How's this week going to work? What's continuing? What's not? When am I doing what? Let's get to it, all right? Tomorrow is Monday. On Monday, my very first stream is going to be Leighton versus Wright. That's right. If you were here on Saturday and you saw the stream and you really enjoyed it, come on back tomorrow for more of the same. I'm very excited because I played the game for 4 hours on Saturday, and I only beat the prologue. I know. What the hell? Apparently the game is incredibly long because going through it, was playing it, and it wasn't like I was being it slow or anything. I wasn't even really stumped by much. I was moving through it pretty fast, and I only beat the prologue after 4 hours. So that continues tomorrow on first stream. And then tomorrow on second stream, since I don't want to start anything new and do anything silly, tomorrow night we're going to be doing a Tales of Exilia 2 stream, okay? So tomorrow's going to be a balance between Leighton versus Wright and Tales of Exilia 2. Tuesday, we've got a new release, and even though I know there's a bunch of stuff that is coming out, you've got a Sherlock Holmes game that's from I don't even know who made it, that's supposed to be coming out. And yes, I do realize that right now there's a Metro 2033 HD redo for the PS4. The bottom line is I'm now in the middle of a ton of games, and I don't want to start new games when I've got all this lingering stuff. So the way that this week is basically going to work is I'm going to be playing Sims 4, which is the new release for this week, and balancing that with Leighton versus Wright. And maybe for variety's sake, at one point, I'll do some more Zillia 2. We'll have to see, okay? But that's the bottom line, is I know that there's other stuff that's out, but I can't overload myself. If I overload myself, I'm never going to finish anything. So that's how I'm going to be handling it. First stream on Tuesday is going to be The Sims 4, where I'm going to, for the very first time, be playing The Sims game on PC. I'm going to create my own cast of characters and throw them in there. I already made a couple characters, if you remember, in the demo. I had the create a character demo, and I may actually throw those characters into the game, or I may make new ones. We'll have to see. And we're going to be doing some simming on Tuesday. At some point this week, maybe Wednesday, I'm actually going to be doing Sims 4 with my girlfriend Leanna, because she loves it. And so you guys know, I don't know how many of you know of or check out her content, but she does have a YouTube channel, Panda Lee Games, and she hasn't consistently been uploading to it for a while because of the move and everything. Just recently she started uploading Sims videos to it again in preparation for The Sims 4. She did some Sims 2, Sims 1, Sims 3, The Sims 4 demo like I did, and she's very much anticipating this game because she loves The Sims. So she's going to be even more into The Sims than I am, I'm sure, okay? So at some point, we're going to be doing some co-op where we create our own co-op family that maybe we go back to from time to time and check on and do simming with as well, okay? So that's going to be starting Tuesday, Sims 3 or Sims 4 first stream. Second stream will be Leighton versus Wright. Wednesday, probably the same thing. Thursday, the return of Hate Live after a long hiatus. It's been some 3 weeks or so since we've seen Hate Live because for various reasons. Last week, there were so many game releases, I didn't do it. The week before, we did Ask the King. And let me tell you, this week, of all times, this is the perfect week for Hate Live because we've got a plethora of very important topics to talk about. And no, I'm not just talking about the Jennifer Lawrence and Kate Upton nude pics that leaked all over the internet today. I'm talking about actual, real important topics that need to be discussed because they will relate directly to gaming and to us. So you've got things such as, number one, Twitch TV was bought out by Amazon. Whoa, what does that mean for everything? Number two, Gamergate, this huge controversy that's hit the internet of a certain game designer, developer, who basically was sleeping around with a bunch of dudes in the gaming media trying to, and apparently the controversy is that they gave her either a lot of press attention for her game or maybe overinflated stuff about her game, and now it's all coming out that, wow, game media actually is corrupt. No shit. I've only been saying that for years, but no one listens to me. But now we actually possibly have some evidence about it. And then, of course, the most recent thing that we have is this big wave of swatting, which is people who are big live streamers, right? Streamers who are, you know, they have thousands and thousands of attendees, far bigger than I am, who on a daily basis do that kind of thing, and people who are pranking, which is not a prank, it's a felony, and having police come in and crash their streams, which is absolutely ridiculous. It's dangerous, it's against the law, and it's just out of control. And so we have a ton of stuff to talk about when it comes to Hate Live this week, a lot of things to discuss. So all that and more on Hate Live this week, with all the, quite honestly, with all the topics, the hot topics that we've got going on, I don't know if we have time for a back in the day segment on Hate Live this week, because it may just be topic after topic after topic. And I think they all need to be fleshed out and have a big portion to talk about stuff. So that's Hate Live this week. It's going to be great, okay? And then, of course, that day I'll also have a mainstream, whether it's Sims 4 or Layton versus Wright or whatever, will depend on what you guys are liking more. If you're liking Layton versus Wright, I'll do that on mainstream. If you want more Sims 4, we'll do that on mainstream. We'll see. And then, of course, Friday will be more gameplay. Saturday is only going to be one gameplay stream like usual, okay? It's only going to be one. And then Sunday, this is the big change, ladies and gentlemen. Sunday is returning to Street Fighter. This week, I didn't do Street Fighter on Sunday, and so a lot of people contacted me and were disappointed. Phil, why? I don't watch your content during the week. I've only been watching your Street Fighter, and there was no Street Fighter stream today. What happened? This was an exceptional week because there were so many releases. Next week, since there's only The Sims 4 and I'm juggling other stuff I've already done, we will be doing Street Fighter on the stream, first stream Sunday next week, then the week in preview like right now, and then Tomodachi Life after. And so that's going to be my staple Sunday from now on. We're going to have Ultra Street Fighter 4, first stream, the week in preview, and Tomodachi Life following it, at least for the foreseeable future, okay? So, very exciting, and it's going to be a fun and jam-packed week. Now, I just want to let everyone know, don't feel, oh, but I really like Tales of Exilia 2, Phil, and now you're in you're going to have two other major games going on. Listen, I understand. I totally understand. I told you when I was playing the game last week how disappointed I was that these game developers do this and that they decided to release Tales of Exilia 2 only a week before all these games come out at once. And I knew that it was going to get pushed to the wayside, but I'm not giving up on that game. I'm playing it tomorrow night, and I am going to be playing it whenever I get a chance that I squeeze it in. So there may be a chance besides Monday night, I squeeze it in again sometime this week. The week after, probably not so much, considering that Destiny and NHL 15 are coming out that week, but maybe so. Maybe something will be boring, you know? Maybe, I'll play NHL and people don't like that. Well, then I'll swap it up or whatever, or vice versa. If Destiny sucks, then I'll do something else, right? So we'll see what happens. We'll see what happens, and we'll go from there. So, it's a jam-packed week, the return of the Hateful Truth, oh god. I know, eventually I do have to start reviewing games again, but I guess we actually have to have games out that are worth reviewing, and I haven't really played any recently. Hopefully with games like Layton versus Phoenix Wright, we'll have a reason to review games again, right? So anyway, the return of Hate Live, the return of Ultra Street Fighter 4, Tomodachi Life now becoming a weekly thing, continuation of Layton versus Phoenix Wright, which everyone wants to see, continuation of Zillia 2, Sims 4 is new this week. There's a ton of new fun content coming out this week for you guys. So, thank you for watching. I hope that you will join me for all the new content this week. That's about all I have to say, and I got to get out of here so I can start with Tomodachi Life. So, thanks everyone for being here, whether it was on live stream or on YouTube for the weekend preview. Have a good night, and I hope to see you for all the new gameplay this week. Peace out.